My name is Alexey Mishalkin, and I will speak about the photo-induced anisotropy in azopolymer studied films by spectroscopic and polarimetric parameters. It was done in the framework of a joint project RNA-TRAS+. And here is presented our member groups. First of all, I want to congratulate Konstantin Lashmansky for the appearance of new member of family in his family, and to wish a good health for the child and a new success in his research activity. So here's the outline of my presentation. We will discuss about the photosensitivity media based on azobenzene-containing polymers. Next one is photo-induced motions in azobenzene-containing polymers. I will speak about the obtaining of azopolymers in films, and then the investigation of the properties of these thin films by polarimetric measurements and spectroscopic investigations. And the next will be conclusions. So first of all, the photosensitive media based of azobenzene-containing polymers are very attractive because it uses the cis-trans isomerization of these molecules. And among the different types of photosensitive media, these materials have received the most attention due to rapid and reversible nanoscale photoisomerization. It can be done by polarized light illumination in the ultraviolet and visible region of spectra. And usually the polymer is host materials, and using the light illumination, it can give rise to large scale motions in these films, such as macroscopic mass transport with polarized illumination. It has great potential in various areas, ranging from photonics to biology. The photoisomerization of azobenzenes is the origin of many interesting phenomena and used in different applications, such as molecular machines and holographic recording devices. Usually it involves the passive polymer and photoactive small molecules, such presented here. It's azobenzene. It's we name it azodice or azochromophores. And one of the common features of azobenzene molecules is their strong electronic absorption in the ultraviolet and visible wavelength region. So the motions, photoinduced motions in these materials can be divided into three categories. First of all, it is molecular motions presented here. During this motion, the molecules, azobenzene molecules, transforms from trans to cis and the next trans isomerization. And the chromophore concentration in the direction of polarization is changed. The next category of movement is domain motions. At this level, the polar chromophore movement reorients the polar domains, the polar domains. And the third one is mass level motions. It's about macroscopic motions. It produces macroscopic movement of polymer that can be used for inscribe surface or bulk patterns in the thin films. So first category is molecular level motions. As you can see, it is triggered by the light, polarized light, usually in the ultraviolet region. And the next transformation in the transform can be done by blue light or heat. During the illumination, the molecules having their transition dipole moments perpendicular to the light polarization direction. Since the transition dipole moment vectors of the trans azobenzenes typically coincides with the axis connected with the midpoints of the two benzenes, the molecules are perpendicular to the polarization plane of slides, and they are inert to the incident beam. By on the other hand, the selectivity also originates from the fact that the absorption probability is proportional to the angle between the polarization direction and the chromoform dipole moment axis. So the next category is photoinduced alignment of azobenzene in the domain range. During this illumination, the bilinear polarization the molecules are arranged in the plane that is perpendicular to the polarization of the light, and it leads to the appearing of birefringence and dichroism in these polymer films. And the third one is the most interesting. It is macroscopic level motions of the polymer films. It leads to the Cefax patterning with a higher height. He has presented the IFM image of the polymer film that was illuminated by the polarized light. If we put our sample in the range of interference of two beams, it leads to the forming of periodic patterns on the film surface, on the macrometer size, and the mass migration on this film is strongly depends on the polarization of the interfering beams. So about the obtaining of our azopolymers in films, we used epoxy propyl carbazole as a polymer host, and we acquired the solvent yellow 3. It is azo dye that is commercial available from Sigma Aldrich. By using this scheme of refluxing of polyepoxy propyl carbazole with azo dye, with different weight of azo dye, we obtained three different samples with different weight of our azo dye. It is 0.3 gram, 0.4 gram, and 0.5 gram weight. And with polyepoxy propyl carbazole with a mass of 1 gram, it was combined and dissolved in the toluene, and it was reflux for 8 hours, and the resulting solution was cooled and filtered. Then this solution was spin coated on the glass substrate, and here is presented the scheme of obtaining of thin films during spin coating. It has three stages. First of all, the solution is put on the glass substrate. The second one is rotating of substrate with a rotation of 800 rotation per minute. During this rotation, the solvent is evaporated. And the next one, the thin film is formed, and then it is dried at room temperature for 20 to 24 hours. He's presented one of the obtained thin films. It is the transparent and the visible range. The next one, it was set up, it was constructed the setup for the polarimetric measurements. He's presented the two laser sources. First of all, it is linear laser polarization sources, like as blue lasers. It is illuminated on the our sample by the wave plate lambda lambda divided by 2. We can rotate the linear polarization of the light beam on the sample. And he has presented the scheme polarization states of the illuminated light blue laser and the reading red laser. It is helium neon laser. So the angle of blue laser was changed from the 0 degree up to 180 degree, while the helium neon laser was a constant angle it was 134 degrees. And the next we used polarimeter to the measure the light transmitted through the sample. We have measured the azimuth and ellipticity of light that was transmitted through the sample using Torlaps polarimeter. The next one, it was measured the transmittance spectra of our polymeric films. Using this spectroscopic investigation, it was calculated the refractive index. It is shown in the inside in the figures. It was measured for the three types of our polymer films with 0.3, 0.5, and 0.5 gram per solution. So we can see that after the illumination, we have changes in the transmission spectra. Using these changes and using this transmission, we obtained the refractive index before illumination and after illumination. Before illumination, it is the black line, and after illumination, it is red line. And we calculated the refractive index and the modulation of refractive index before and after illumination. And we have shown that this refractive index modulation, it's about zero for the 0.3 gram. It's about 0.01 for the 0.4 gram of azadai. And the largest refractive index modulation, it's observed for the azopolymer with 0.5 gram of azadais. So the shift in transmission spectra of these azopolymer films after radiation indicates the presence of the cis isomers of azadai, the solvent yellow 3, due to the photoisomerization process during the illumination. The next one was the polarimetric investigation independence of exposure angle and chromophore concentration. Here is presented three types of our samples. It is 0.3, 0.4, then 0.5 gram of azadai. It was determined the thickness of obtained films. It was it is shown here. And to study the photoinduced changes in azimuth ellipticity of these films with these parameters, we measured the kinetics of the change in degree of polarization, and we have choose the exposure time like 6 minutes. It's about 360 seconds. Where the saturation take place. So we compared these three our samples, and the polarization plane of illuminated light was changes from 0 degree up to 180 degree with a step of 10 degree. And the exposure of material was done by the blue laser at 473 nanometers in 6 minutes for every exposure. So here is the presented results of temporal changes of azimuth angle for each angle of polarization from 0 degree up to 170 degree for each type of our polymer films. Every 6 minutes, we changed the polarization angle. And from these curves, we can see the cyclical change of azimuthal angle, which directly indicates the reversibility of the process associated with the photoinduced changes in the position of the molecules in the volume of the azopolymer. At the same time, the relationship is observed between the maximum angle of the azimuth and the thickness of the polymer of the azopolymer thin films. So it can be assumed that increasing the film thickness leads to a decrease in the azimuth angle of the reading beam, laser beam that is transmitted through the sample during the illumination. The next time is the investigation of ellipticity of red laser beam. He's presented the same three types of our other polymers with different other day concentration. And like azimuth, the ellipticity is the same change cyclically over the time. And it can be assumed that the maximum value of ellipticity depends on the concentration of the chromophore in the other polymer films. So the next time it's graphs of dependence of the azimuth and ellipticity, is azimuth and films ellipticity, on the rotation angle of the probe laser beam. During this experiment, the illumination light was constant, but the probing laser beam was rotated the same by from the 0 degree up to 180 degree. And he has presented the azimuth dependence and ellipticity dependence of the red laser beam, from which it can be clearly distinguished that the azimuth average from the for the given samples is proportional for the film thickness, while the ellipticity depends on the concentration of the other dye. And it have a decrease value with the increasing of the concentration of other dye. So some conclusion, in summary, the photoinduced anisotropy of our azopolymer film based on polyepoxypropyl carbazole and solvent yellow 3 was investigated. For it, we used a blue laser at 473 nanometers. It was determined that refractive index of azopolymer in films depends on chromophore concentration. And during the illumination, the changes of refractive index is different for different azopolymer concentration and consists about 0.3 gram of azodye, and the refractive index modulation is about 0.01 for the 0.4 gram of azopolymer dye. And the maximum value of refractive index modulation is about 0.03. And it corresponds for the other polymer with the other dye about 0.5 gram per solution. Also, the maximum azimuth change was achieved in the sample with a mass ratio of 0.3 gram per solution, while ellipticity reaching 49. It was shown that an increase in the azimuth angle increases with an increase in the thickness of the polymer films, while the increase in ellipticity occurs as the concentration of the chromophore in the polymer decreases. And for the sample with mass ratio of 0.3 gram, the maximum value of ellipticity reached 1.3 for the right azimuth and minus 1.62. For the left azimuth position. So I want to thank the project that was founded our research. It is RNET RAS Plus project, and thank you for your attention. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Alexei. So are there any questions, please? Okay, if not, may I have one? So if I may misunderstood something, but depending on the polarization of the lasers, do you have more lines in the interference patterns or less lines on the same size or not? Is there any dependency?
It's no dependence on the polarization state of the illuminated light. The, the interference pattern depends only on the thickness and the refractive index of our sample.
So no dependence on polarization?
No dependence on polarization.
But only the depths and the material depends on the polarization or not?
Yes, thickness of materials depends.
Okay, thank you. So